Do you understand the concept of the truncated V? This concept is very useful whenever you want to apply appropriate force systems to achieve specific tooth movements, especially when you are working with transpalatal arches, lingual arches, and roof springs. Let's take a look to a very common example. The derotation of first molars is a very common problem found in both mixed and permanent dentition. The best force system to solve this problem is the application of two equal and opposite moments. A force system also known as a geometry 6 force system. Let's consider we will use a TPA to achieve our goal to solve this problem. As always, we will start by making a passive TPA. The orthodontic literature has shown that if we use a wire with a central V-band, we can produce a geometry 6 force system. However, if we make a central V-band in a TPA, this appliance will be too rigid. It will probably break when inserted into the molar tubes. Even if it were possible, the forces produced would be so high and non-physiological for safe tooth movements. So how can we deal with this problem? Let's understand the solution. If we insert one end of the TPA on the right side here, for example, we can check a certain distance from the entry of the tube to the end of the arch. Let's call this distance X. If we insert the other extremity of the appliance, we will see exactly the same distance on the other side, because we have a central V-band. The truncated V is the solution to increase the flexibility of this appliance. Let's see. Let's imagine that we will apply a kind of karate strike here and virtually break this central V-band. In reality, we will transform this central V-band into two terminal bands. We will make one band into one extremity and another band at the other extremity, in a way that the two bands are equal. They have the same degree of intensity. So we have kept the symmetry of the preactivation. It's very easy to check. We can now see a certain distance X between the tube and the extremity of the TPA, and we will check exactly the same distance on the other side. So basically, we have transformed one central V-band into two terminal bands. We have kept the same degree of the bands, so we have kept the geometry 6 force system, our desired force system. Repeating the preactivations, two terminal bands with the same intensity. When we insert this preactivated transpalatal bar, its deactivation will produce exactly the force system that we want. This is force-driven orthodontics. This is a very precise and effective tooth movement. If you want to apply a different force system corresponding to a different geometry, you will follow the same principle. By achieving the appropriate proportion of the geometric relationships of the geometries, we can produce any force system corresponding to the 6 geometries. I hope you have enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you in our next orthodontic tip.